Hi, my name's Shipp, and you join me on an absolutely stunning canal. This is called the Kennett Avon Canal. It's in between Devizes and Chippenham. And I've brought you back to my old roots. This is a canal that I used to fish, and even this stretch I used to fish a long, long time ago. It's different now. Back then, there was lots of carp, lots of tench. There was even lots and lots of cruisings. I think now it's a lot different. There's a lot of roach, lots of skimmers. So I thought, what a great opportunity. Now the boat traffic's calmed down. There's not so much people walking about and push bikes. This is a great time of year to come out onto a canal such as this one and have a great day's fishing. So I'm gonna show you the little tips on baits, floats, elastics, because it is very, very different to what you do on commercials. So let's start off. I'm gonna run you through all the little baits. How am I gonna tap me peg? And all the crucial stuff before we actually start fishing. First things first, let's go through the bait. Now, one of the crucial things today, I think, is going to be ground bait. Now, when I come here this morning, we've only had two cold days, and as you can see, the leaves are still, they're still on the trees. They're not really coming off really heavily yet, so we're not into the depth of winter. As soon as I seen the colour of this canal is quite a coloured canal. You get a lot of boat traffic. Obviously, when we go through winter and the boats stop, this will clear out. Now, as soon as I seen it, I thought I'm gonna use a natural color ground bait today. And what I've kept it nice and simple. I've mixed up a bag of So Natural Lake, the natural color, because I think it's something you've got to think about when you fish these sort of natural venues. You know, do you fish a dark ground bait? Do you fish a light ground bait? When I'm fishing for the fish that I'm gonna be fishing for today, which are little roach, skimmers, hopefully we'll catch a couple of better sized skimmers because we'll have a chopped worm line in as well. I just thought it makes complete sense. So I've actually just mixed up a kilo. I've got a bit of the ground bait there, which is just nice, which you can just bind together. But I've also done some slop. So I've got the same ground bait and I've mixed this up really wet. I might not use that, but if things get tough and I can just start chucking an odd little sloppy ball in, it can make a big difference on these canals. So I've just got a bit of slop there. Like I said, I don't know if I'm going to use it, but obviously we'll talk about that as we get going. Other baits for today. I've got some big maggots, hardly anything, literally half a pint of red and white maggots with a couple of fluoros in it. One of the crucial baits today for certain is going to be pinkies. So I've brought like half a pint, three quarters of a pint of pinkies, just mixed. Got some fluoros in there, fluoros, whites and reds. I think fluoros are gonna be the main sort of bait for today, really. And then I've got the faithful chopped worms, some dendrobinas, like that. So I've probably bought like half a kilo of dendrobinas. I've already chopped some up, ready. And what we'll do, we'll talk about, you know, when I'm fishing, we'll talk about where I'm fishing, what rigs I'm fishing and things like that, because I can't wait to get going. So I've got some chopped worm there and that's it. And that's all you need on a canal like this. You don't need loads of bait. You just need a nice selection of baits, a nice selection of rigs and floats, which I'll talk to you about as we get going. So the first thing I'm going to do is get me balls of ground bait ready, you know, put the ingredients in it that I want and then start fishing. I'm ready to go now. I've just mixed me pinkies in with me ground bait. I am trying to keep this really, really simple today. I don't think it's cold enough yet to start messing about with, you know, squats. I am looking to catch better quality fish. And I think pinkies, chopped worms and baits like that, big maggots are perfect. So what I've done, I've put enough ground bait in this little EVA bowl. I've put some pinkies in. I've decided I'm going to feed two balls short because that's where I'm going to start. So a top kit plus three. And just talking about the canal a little bit, on every canal you go to, you always get a boat channel. And the fish seem to hang around. The big fish like eels, tench, you know, perch, you can catch sort of down the deep water. But I find a lot of the canals, you've got a fish sort of just as it starts to come off the boat channel. That's where the roach, the skimmers, you know, sort of 3 foot, 4 foot of water seems to be the best sort of bait. Unless you've got some cover right over and you can fish up to that with casters, you can catch big roach. But today I'm just keeping it nice and simple, trying to catch over ground bait, and hopefully we'll catch a few fish over chopped worms. So I've got enough ground bait in here to make 5 balls up. So that's 3 long at 13 meters and 2 short. So not making them really, really hard. I've just got a nice mix there. It's just damp enough to hold them together with a few pinkies in. Obviously you can add whatever you like. You can put some squats in it, some casters. I've just tried to keep it nice and simple. And I know on this canal, big maggot and pinkies are a great bait for a great day's fishing. So that's perfect in there to make 5 balls. Like that. So the first thing I do is obviously feed my short line first, because that's where I'm going to start. And what we'll do, we'll talk a bit more about how I thumbed up and all the technical stuff as we start fishing. So just cut them in short. 2 balls. You see that that natural ground bait fizzing, it fizzes. That's why natural ground bait on these sort of venues are really, really good. And then stick the rest of the sections on. So that's 13 meters. So it's sort of out of the way of the boat traffic. I don't think we're going to get many boats today, because it has gone sort of off the peak of people on holiday and things like that. And as I said, it's a great time to come onto a canal. I can't, you know, it is. You can have an awesome day if you pick the right day. So again, 13 meters. It's just a little bit shallower there than what it is on a top kit plus 3. And I'm putting a little bit more bait there short than I am short, because I'll probably leave that. Normally on these canals, you can have a real good run short and then you've got to go long. The fish just back off. We've got a couple of joggers going past a minute. So 3 balls long. Get them in. And then off to an angle, the same distance, 13 meters, I've come down the slope. It's sort of down to the bottom of the slope, and that's where I'm going to put my worm line in. So that's sort of my bonus fish line. And I'll probably, as the day goes on, I'll probably loose feed pinkies on this long line. Let's get some chopped worm in there. So I'm going to put a bit in, actually. I'm going to put just over a quarter of a pot of chopped worms in like that. And like I said, this is going to be slightly off to an angle. Now, the angle is important, because on most canals, it runs certain ways. And I know the canal runs that way, which is down, basically downstream, because you've got the locks down there, which are lower. So there's actually a nice fish just top there, which is good news. So off to an angle, I got myself lined up with a tree opposite. Get that in there. And I'm gonna have to look after that. You know, I'll top that up as we go along. So top kit plus 3, I think that's a 3, that one. This is where I'm going to start. Let's get everything out of the way. And then when we get fishing, I'll talk you through all the rigs, because the rigs are really, really important on a canal such as the Kennett Avon. It is different to commercials. So I'm going to get fishing and I'll run you through all the bits and pieces as we're going. I've got another little dumpy pommy or skimmer on. Caught some absolutely lovely fish. But these are your sort of bread and butter fish, if you like, for a little canal, like 2-3 ounce fish. They're absolutely freezing cold. Let's get in back and I'll run you through one of the crucial things about this style of fishing, are the floats and the setups, because it does make a big, big difference on canals. I'll start off with the rig that I'm using right this minute, which is basically one of the new natural float rings called the Shipper. As you can see, it's very, very short. And when you're fishing canals such as I am today, like the Kennett Avon, believe you me, little stumpy floats like that make a huge difference. I mean, with the boats going up and down, there's a lock just down from us. And what you'll find as well, that the canals and venues like canals, they skim really badly. These little floats work amazingly. They sit brilliant. They are very, very sensitive, admittedly, but when you're squat, pinky fishing, bread punch fishing, even with blubberman joker, if you do that style of fishing, these floats make a huge difference. I mean, I just literally caught that fish, and because there's a boat coming at the moment, the canal was really pushing, but they just sit so, so well, you know. And shotting pattern, really, I've actually got a strung out shotting pattern on here. So I've got number 11 shot, because it is quite what I call hairy fairy sort of fishing sometimes when you're fishing for canals, even though I've got other rigs made up as well. But that's what I call rig for fishing long, where I'm pinging a few pinkies over the top, over ground bait, and I'm catching everything. And I've caught a couple of bonus fish, fishing just a little bit more over depth. I mean, when I first went out on this rig, I could probably have fished a sort of a thicker inserted float, but when I'm trying to fish, trying to catch everything, these little shippers work fantastically. They really, really do. 012 main line, because we are fishing canals, so I've brought my main lines down. Obviously, I'm not on the commercial. The main lines make a lot of difference to your float presentation. 012 on this canal, for what I'm doing today, is absolutely fine. And sometimes, if you're fishing with the really, really small floats in this range, you might even go down to 010 main line. When you're trying to catch fish on the drop, like little roach and things like that, if you're a match angler, 010 does make a big difference. So that's the first rig. That's the rig I'm fishing at 13 meters. And to be honest, it's been the best rig. So let's go for everything else that I've made up. I've actually set another shipper up. This is for my short line. It's obviously a little bit deeper. That's a 0.4. I've blacked it out because I'm fishing into sort of silver water. There's a nice big boat going past at the moment. Same main line, 012, number 3 slip elastic. And on this rig, it's really simple. This was my short line that I actually started on. I've got a simple bulk of number 9s and I've got one number 10 dropper. So it's really, really positive. And when you start on a canal, on that short line, you can fish really, really positive. You know, literally, the fish are on your ground bait. It's more about getting your rig in there, catching the fish that are in your peg as quick as possible. I didn't actually stay on this for long because I just felt with my ground bait activating long, there were some better quality fish. And as it happens, when I went out there, I've not looked back. I've caught some nice fish. I've caught better than what I was catching short. Short, I caught a couple of little dumpy skimmers. But that long line is definitely the place to be at the moment. So that's the line that I've, oh, that's the float I've set up for top kit plus 3. But there's one other float, or two other floats I've made up. One is this polo float, what they call a polo. It's a pencil style float. These are really, I set this up because when I love pencil floats, when I'm fishing in such as a venue like this, which is like a slow moving canal, if you like, these are awesome when you're letting your bait go through your peg. They really, really are, because they strike through the water really, really well, because they're obviously really straight. So I've set a pencil float up. I'm not using it at the moment. I'm just sticking with the shippers, because over there, that is definitely the best float. When it's sort of towing through and I want to hold on to it, that float works really, really well. But I've set that up just in case it was going to be the situation where I needed to let my bait trundle through the peg off the bottom. That's when them pencil floats make a big difference. I remember some matches I fished at Barston with Bloodworm, and they were always my first float out of the bag when I wanted to catch roach and skimmers fishing off the bottom. That pencil float for me does it the best. It strikes through the water really well, and I don't know, there's something about them when you want to trundle your bait through, they just work amazing. Simple bulk again, and I got two little number 10 droppers, but I've not really fished with that yet. The other float I've made up for today's session is my chop worm rig. Obviously, when we start talking about chop worm, we're talking about being more positive. You know, bigger hooks, thicker lines. So I've actually set up a 0.5. That's all I need today to hold bottom on this canal. The deepest part of this canal is probably 4.5 to 5 foot. I've actually not been on this line yet, but I will be as the session goes along. I've actually got a 6 slip on there because I'm fishing with chopped worms. I'm looking to catch better quality fish. 0.5 power. The power is a perfect float. The whole range has got nickel titanium wire, so it's very, very stable. And if you bend it, it just goes back to how it was. They're perfect for every style of fishing, and you can't go wrong. Hollow bristle, slightly thicker, obviously more positive. You know, I've fished about 3 inches over depth with worms. Even though I've not gone on it yet, there's a couple of boats that have gone through. I've actually primed them back up with a bit of chopped worm again. 014 AccuPower mainline, a little bit stronger because I'm obviously fishing with different hook lengths. Simple bulk of number nines, and I got 2 number 9 droppers. And then down to a 16 N20 hook. They're all pre-tied. Even the N10s that I'm using on my pinky rig, they're pre-tied, which is just, you just take them with you. It doesn't get easier. You just carry them around in the Magstore system like that. You just get them off, start fishing with them. So I'm actually fishing with a 16 N20 for me chop worm, but on the other lines, I'm fishing with a 20 to 08 N10. They're slightly different hook. The N10 has got a longer shank, which is absolutely ideal for when you're fishing with bread punch, pinkies, squats, maggots, and baits like that. Obviously they're barbed, so that's why they're actually colored in red. All the red Magstore systems are actually for barbed hooks. So there you go, that's a little rundown of what I'm fishing with. I can't wait to get back out because it is really, really nice fishing. I've actually topped up twice now on that ground bait line. I'm firing a few pinkies over the top. See if I can find my little rig again. But this rig is honestly, them little Shipper floats, if you're into your canal fishing, or even if you're going to a natural lake and you're fishing with pinkies, you know, bread punch like we do in the winter, them floats will not let you down. And also with the pencil floats as well, the polos, they are awesome little floats. Let's get a single pinky's been the best bait. It's a size 20 hook. Elastic through one section. Let's see if I can just go out. And as soon as a boat goes past, I literally see where the boat goes. If it goes over my line long, I put a little ball in like that with a few more pinkies in. But I have been loose feeding a few pinkies over the top as well. There you go, look at that, straight in. That boat's just gone past while we've been filming. I've just gone straight in. Them float, them little Shippers, honestly, that little style of float like that works amazing. It's great to catch little fish like this on the Kennett Avon Canal. Look at them, little dumpy. That's actually a little pommy again. It's full of them. Some of these canals are actually full of these little pommies. And when you weigh in at the end, whether you're a match angler or a pleasure angler, you'll be amazed what they weigh. So that was immediately, and that's on that little strung out rig. And that strung out rig gives you just versatility, really. I can go out there, because obviously I've been feeding pinkies with a catapult over the top. If later in the session, things change, the fish have come off the bottom, there's some bigger roach to be caught. Just having that strung out rig like that just gives you the versatility of catching on the drop as well. I mean, that one, literally, I just flicked it down the canal like that. I'm just going to pick my catapult up. Fing a few pinkies as well, because it's actually slowed down, that boat's gone. And because they're really sensitive, them floats, they're brilliant for catching those little fish as well. The float just goes under because they're really sensitive. And you don't have to dot them right down. You can have a bit of the bristle showing because they're really sensitive. You don't have to, if you don't want to, dot it right down to a pimple. And that's actually skimming quite bad, that canal now, but them floats sit there, well, unbelievable. And you don't, you know, when you're fishing sort of three foot of water on a little canal like that, you don't really want a really, really long float for catching little fish. You stick with them little stumpy floats and they definitely work much, much better. And I'm just holding it dead still. Because I've caught some better quality fish, I sort of feel like I want to hold it still. I want to be fishing on the bottom. I'm not really interested in coming off the bottom yet until things change. I want to try and catch the better quality fish. There we go. Oh, yes. Isn't that brilliant? For the camera as well, just looked a nice big well, hopefully it's one of those big, great big silver bream again. And then, honestly, I can't really begin to explain how good them little floats are, how they sit on a skimming canal. There's certain floats that I've used in my life for this style of fishing, and you cannot beat that little style of float. That's a proper fish by the feel of that. I know a lot of people don't go canal fishing anymore, but honestly, try it. Now the winter's, you know, we're getting into winter mode again. You can have some absolute awesome days. And I've never fished this stretch before, this bit I'm fishing on. I don't know what's in here, but you can go anywhere. That feels like a bream. Take your time. Let's see, fishing light bottoms, 08. Oh yes. You don't get better for that, for the cameras, let me tell you. Oh, I didn't even, you know, you wouldn't even think that fish was in your peg. 3.5 foot of water. Oh, look at that, Kennett Avon Canal. Don't get better. Perfectly hooked. Number 3 elastic. Brilliant. One good skimmer. I was fishing short at the start and I was catching some little dumpy skimmers, little dumpy roach. And I thought, I looked at my long line and you could see the, after about sort of half an hour, you could see the ground baiting, all the ground bait all activating like mad. That's a nice little, that's actually a pommy that. Look at that, that's a typical little Kennett Avon Canal pommy. It's like a silver bream, what they call silver bream. Not a skimmer, it's actually a species. Lovely little fish then. They do weigh as well, but I've had a nice skimmer probably getting on for a pound and a half. Yeah, and I went out, seen all the ground bait, all the bits, so it's all shimmering on the top. So I went out there, started fishing with a pinky, and it was sort of never went under really, and I thought there might be some quality fish there. So I put a little bit more line on the bottom, probably fishing about 2 inches over depth now, and being nice and patient. I've had one good skimmer. I mean, how long that'll last, I don't know. I've just started throwing a few pinkies on that short line. So I was catching all right there, but I couldn't miss the opportunity of, you know, because you do get that on canals. Sometimes on your long line, even though you're catching short, if you think there is some quality fish about, you've got to go over. So this is on the actual 13 meter ground bait line. I've not gone on my chop worm line yet. And I'm just sitting there. I've got a little point 3.5 float on. There we go, little fish then. And that's what happens on this canal. If you go over and don't get a bite, sometimes it's because you've got quality fish in your peg. And that's what happened. It's a little roach. You've got to put up with this a little bit on canals. And the next bite can be like a could be a 2 pound skimmer. It can be a 6 ounce roach. You just don't know. It's really nice fishing. So I've been fishing like 40 minutes. Just drop that in. I have been starting to loose feed a few pinkies over there. I just fancied that today, with the conditions being quite nice as well. Because this can drag like some good quality roach and that in your peg. And I might have to top that up in a minute. And after catching a skimmer of like a pound and a half, I'm sort of thinking, there's another little baby fish then, little roach that was, come off. I'm thinking to myself, should I just put a few chop worms in the next ball of ground bait to give me that option of maybe putting a bit of a worm on? It was so obvious though when I went out there and the float was just, I could see all the ground bait shimmering on the top and I thought I couldn't get a bite and I thought there's a quality fish there. And I come back in, moved me float up 2 inches. So I just put a little bit of line on the bottom, went out, caught a nice skimmer of a pound and a half, caught a couple of little pommies, you know, and the pommies are like 4 ounces, a nice little fish. Another little roach. So I'll see, just carry on with this a minute. And if I carry on catching little fish like that, I'll probably end up putting another ball in. This little tiny baby skimmer, that. Just fishing a number three elastic, three slip elastic, and I actually got that through a one section. That's how I used to fish the canals all them years ago, and I still fish them now if I fish a canal. I think it's absolutely perfect. It's good for the little fish, and it's obviously, it's really good when you catch a better quality fish so they don't start running down your peg. If you're fishing real light elastics, you can sort of get out of control of a better sized fish. But if you fish it through one section, it does power up a lot faster. You just see me out, you see me ground bait just starting to shimmer again. So hopefully it might be a better sized fish there. They do give themselves away sometimes with natural ground baits because it does shimmer because of all the hemp and oils that are in the natural ground baits. But it might just be where the little fish have come back. There we go. All right, what did I say? That was perfect timing. Now, that's a nice fish again, that. That is a nice fish, actually. Ooh, that is proper fudding. That's lovely. On a canal, it don't get better. When you get on a few fish like that, I'm only fishing 08 bottoms, you know, little size 20 hook. Just take your time. I could just sense that there was one there. I just thought, well, it's either a load of little fish that have come in me peg, or a better quality fish. Another nice skimmer, I think. It's beautiful fishing. You know, freezing cold morning. Look at him. I'm hoping that's a great big, that looks like a hybrid. Oh, yes. Oh, that's beautiful. That is a big, big pommy. A big silver bream. It don't get better than that. That is not a skimmer. If you look at his eye, you've got that massive eye. So these are the sort of fish you catch on the River Trent and things like that, or places like that. I mean, that is an absolute stunning a canal pommy. What an absolute beautiful fish that is. Over a pound. Very special fish that, to be honest, on a canal to catch that. And on the camera for you guys as well. Let's get him back. When I caught that little fish last time we chopped worm, I've put probably like 50 mil of chopped worm in, and I went back on my ground bait 30 meter line. I've had a nice little run there of some dumpy, I keep calling them dumpy roach, nice little pommies. But then the same really, I've caught a couple of little fish and I thought I'd just go back on my chopped worm line. There we go, that's on chopped worm. Only a little fish. And really, that's what I'm just doing at the moment. This last sort of hour. Lovely catching those little pommies though. But I've had an awesome day. But definitely topping up. You've had to top up. And I've changed things around slightly. As soon as I caught a few quality fish, I thought, right, I'm just going to put a few worms in with me ground bait. So when I've topped up, after sort of the first time I topped up with just ground bait and pinkies, I then topped up with a little bit of ground bait. A little bit of worm in my ground bait as well, which seems to have made a lot of difference. I mean, that worm is amazing. Little tiny fish on them. The first time I went out on my worm line, there was some quality fish there. Not the sort of fish we've caught on that ground bait, admittedly. I've not had no real stamp fish, which you'd think would be the other way round. But them skimmers and that have definitely come to ground bait today. Just changing between red maggot and pinky. I just thought maybe we could have had some better quality fish on worms, but that's canals for you. But ground bait with the colour this morning, the cold air last night, and I thought, I looked at the colour and I thought, ground bait's going to be. I've just had a feeling ground bait could be really, really good today, and it's proved that it actually was. I've had some lovely skimmers, you know, some quality pommies or silver bream. And I've just put another little ball in just before I've back on my chop worm line, just to see. Because really, your chop worm line, when you fish a canal like this, is about your bonus line. It's maybe you catch a big bream, a big perch, you know, eels. You just never know. Perhaps I should have mixed a bit of ground bait in with my worm at the start, but that's in, you know, hindsight's a lovely thing. I just thought I'd put it in neat just to sort of catch everything. You know, sometimes you might catch some big perch. Oh, there we go. Oh, you don't get better than that. It just went dead, and everything that I've done today on each line, every time it's gone dead, I felt like you've had a quality fish in your peg. So that's on me worm line. That's the biggest fish I've hooked on me worm line. And I think it's a fantastic fish to probably finish this film off. It's just started raining, so I think it's a good time anyway, because I hate getting wet. I'm actually going to carry on fishing because I've absolutely enjoyed every second of this today. I think it's a skimmer. Hopefully it's never one of those great big silver bream again, but I don't think it is. I hope it is. Oh, and it is. Wow, that is awesome. What a great fish to finish this film off. Another Kennett Avon Canal silver bream. You can see his little orange fins. Sometimes you go to venues that are really, really clear and them fins are really, really orange. So what a great fish to finish it off. God, he's really had that as well. So that was on just a little bit of a dendra. Look at that, absolutely fantastic. It's made my day, that. Catching those sort of fish in this country on canals like that, it doesn't get better. Let's get him back. So like I said, if you take the tips that you've learned today, rigs are really, really important. Like them little Shipper floats for fishing out there, there ain't nothing better. How they sit on a skimming canal. We've got a little bit of wind, skimming. It makes a big, big difference. The shore has not been that good really. Good for little fish, but as soon as I've gone long today, it was so obvious, the bigger stamp fish, even like the 3-4 ounce fish. We caught a couple at the start, but honestly, them 2 13-meter lines over ground bait, chop worm. Now I'm gonna carry on because it's really enjoyable. But there you go. I hope you picked up some nice tips on how to fish canals such as the Kennett Avon Canal. And thanks for watching, and see you on the bank sometime.